of Myanmar. More with the people in the U.S. and congregations there, and we ask for your prayer and financial support for the plan we have, and also for the furthering of theological training in Southeast Asia and Myanmar.
I guess I'll come in instead of being the disembodied voice and say, Martin, I'm impressed by the way that you've thought of what the different educational needs are for theological students. And I want people to understand that what we're really talking about first is training church workers, the strategy of the Lutheran Church of Myanmar is to build children's educational centers, nursery schools, if you will, after-school programs, things like that, in different areas of Myanmar. And so he needs to train, and does, on his own, evangelists.
Yes.
Evangelists. So we had about 20 registered in the seminar.
That's right.
And it ranges all the way from some pretty young people, but some of them, like Juwan Han, have been given big responsibility so that they
as a missionary in a Shan state.
And she'd have about 2 dozen children there. Mm-hmm. And they have to be very discerning and sensitive because they're working in Buddhist families, and
that's right.
And they'll be teaching the children Christian songs, but they can't teach them too many Christian songs, right?
Right.
There's a tension there. Myanmar is a strongly Buddhist country. The type of Buddhism here is very active, and they're protective of their culture. But then, in our training, then we have some people who have been to, they have a Bachelor of Theology, mm-hmm. a couple of people that go to India for that, then you have a couple of young pastors, and you have older experienced pastors.
That's right.
Probably none of these people, thank you, dude. None of these people really were raised Lutheran besides yourself.
That's right. That's right.
Yeah, you were raised Lutheran because your father, who was a Presbyterian, mm-hmm. He used to use Martin Luther's small catechism in his teaching.
Yeah.
He actually moved to, this is the story I know, he moved to Rangoon, now Yangon.
To become a missionary here.
To found a church.
Yeah,
and he even was working with some Baptists. They didn't care if he was Presbyterian or Lutheran. They saw in him a vibrant Christianity and an intelligence, and they wanted him to be the pastor. So that is the seed of the Lutheran Church of Myanmar. So you were essentially raised Lutheran in the Lutheran family. Yeah, so this is what God does. And in Southeast Asia, we're working in three different countries, and in each country is a different story. We've been asked to come. It's like the this Paul had a vision, he was invited to come to Europe. He didn't go to Europe until he was invited.
That's right.
We didn't come to Southeast Asia until we were invited. And we're coming very specifically, you know, we're not coming as a colonial empire, but in each country we're going to do what we're asked.
That's right.
And now, the other thing that if people are considering supporting this financially with their financial gifts, they should understand that in this country, you already have a partner, and has been this group within inside the Evangelical Lutheran Church of Finland, called LEAF, the Lutheran Evangelical Association of Finland. They do mission around the world, and for over 100 years. So they're very experienced, and they generally come to a national group with a plan, or they build a plan with you. So they started supporting you in like 2013. Something like that?
Yeah.
Yeah. So
3 years back.
3 years back. They actually were able to come in after you were working with this group of Australians that helped build the Damati.
That's right.
Yeah. So we'll have more information, and people can call me up. You know, you can find my information through the ILT website, which is just ILT.org. And we can tell you more about these partnerships and these wonderful things that are actually... I have to meet Pastor August Frick. He seems to be behind an awful lot of things here.
That's
in Asia.
Right. He's the first person who came in contact with us while we need help for raising up the church and also expanding our mission work in this country. So we are indebted to Pastor August Frick and his agency, mission agency called Asia Focus. Without them, we might not have the Damati Hall as well.
So he works within the Lutheran Church of Australia.
Yeah, he's a retired pastor of the Lutheran Church of Australia. And then the Asia Focus mission team come to Myanmar every year since 2007. So we've been working together for more than nearly 10 years now.
Yeah. So. Well, I don't want to do too long a video. I want people to watch it. And if I talk too much, they might switch channels. So let me thank you. And again, I'm so happy that I said yes, that I came. I think that a lot of people and a lot of pastors in LCMC, once they hear how nice it is here, and how the people are so friendly. And then everybody should have the experience of worshiping at their church in downtown Myanmar. The children and the people sing so beautifully. And they're going to be, if you contact me, I'll tell you about opportunities for mission trips. We should plan to get involved in an annual youth camp here. If we could connect sort of the same themes and what's going on in the LCMC annual gathering, the youth gathering, and have a kind of a sister relationship with the youth here. There's so many wonderful things that what we as people from North America, you know, will really be the beneficiaries of. It's not anything like, we're doing any kind of charity. The reward is in the coming and in the sharing of the fellowship and in seeing the love of God being made tangible in these, being made tangible. So thank you,
thank
Pastor
you
Martin.
Very much.
This is great. Thank you for having us.
And I would like to invite all the mission team, including the youth mission team or women mission team or whatever you call it, to Myanmar whenever you like to come, so that we'll be able to work together through the mission team, and you can experience the country and the people and the situation we're facing here, so that you can explore more about the possibility of our mission expansion in this country, and also share the love of God to people all around the country. So, thank you very much.
Did we say yet that the Christian presence in this country is, you know, 5 to 8%, and the Lutheran percentage is 0.000.
Very small.
It is not yet. How do the statisticians say? Significantly important, or whatever. But also, lastly, people can talk to Pastor Mark Vandertyke, the servant leader of LCMC, and Pastor Tom Lovan with Lutheran Asian Ministries. We're working with all these people, and I invite people to just to explore at least how you might plug in here. Okay? Thank you, and God bless. God bless.